Pledge battle at the State House heats up. Anger and opposition. Hundreds showed up to testify Wednesday, protesting Governor Chafee's sales tax overhaul plan.
And now the House Speaker says Chafee's two-tiered sales tax is unacceptable and would be rejected as it is right now.
So we wanted to know what happens next. Iowa News reporter Sean Daly, live in Providence with the latest. Sean.
Yes, Patrick, with a major change now in play. And I have to say, with church bells here in the background, maybe as some sort of a sign, the budget battle is back on here at the State House. Governor Lincoln Chafee's plan to add more sales taxes as a way to help close a huge budget deficit appears now to be dead, at least in its current form. The opposition was overwhelming. Angry taxpayers spilled out of a House Finance Committee hearing room yesterday and into a hallway in the basement of the State House. Their message was consistent and clear: no new taxes. We took a walk and a listen. Tell me why you're here.
I'm a farmer, and we don't need to pay any more taxes.
Tell me why you're here, sir.
We have enough taxes already. We don't need to be creating new ones all the time.
How about you? What brings
save
you
my
here?
Business.
Eventually, even the hallway got too crowded, so an overflow room was set up with a TV hooked up to the hearing room.
In opposition to this bill.
Eventually, last night, after listening to hours of testimony against Governor Lincoln Chafee's plan to expand the state sales tax, the House Finance Committee ended the hearing. House Speaker Gordon Fox then rejected the Chafee plan as a way to help fill about half of Rhode Island's $331 million budget hole. Quote, the House will not pass the budget in its current form. We will instead develop alternatives to this proposal and will continue to work with the governor to amend his budget submission. Governor Chafee quickly followed up with a statement of his own. Quote, I look forward to working with Chairman Mello and Speaker Fox to advance an honest, responsible budget that fixes our chronic structural deficits and puts Rhode Island on a path to prosperity. So now comes the political wheeling and dealing. This situation is very much in flux at the moment. We'll be tracking down both Governor Chafee and Speaker of the House Gordon Fox, and we'll have the very latest on Eyewitness News, starting on Eyewitness News at 5. Live at the State House with the Providence Mobile Newsroom, Sean Daly, Eyewitness News.